You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
It's warming up, folks, and about time to turn on your AC unit and cross your fingers. Or you can give up that moment of truth and switch to an American Standard heat pump system like I did. My place is on comfort autopilot thanks to American Standard. Energy efficient and reliable, my heat pump keeps things cool like the Arctic in the summer. And with energy incentives, I was able to save. Ready for the future of comfort? Learn more at AmericanStandardAir.com/electrification.
Places, please. The Daly Migs Show is on deck. Guitars plugged in. Drums ready to go. Chickens. They're a-clucking. Other animals. And action.
This is the Daly Migs Show on The Rock with Taryn Daly and Steve Migs.
While listening to the Daly Migs Show, please refrain from any unnecessary finger gesturing.
99.9 KISW.
What is shaking, rockaholics? Happy Tuesday. Steve Migs, I have a fashion question for you.
You're going to ask me.
Well, I'm going to ask
you. The fashionista of this show.
You and Danny both, actually.
The fashionistas.
I'm leaving Sarah out of this because it's about hats. Here's why.
Okay.
I feel like when you wear, like, a baseball cap, you are a Bill Forward guy.
Yes.
I feel like I see Danny do a little bit of both. When you're working, I feel like it's backwards mostly.
Yeah.
But do you ever put your hat backwards?
I don't, because I think it looks weird when you're bald.
Oh.
Really?
Because I don't wear fitted caps. If I wore a fitted cap, I feel like I could pull it off. No problem.
You were the one with the little meshies.
I like the meshies. The trucker-style caps is usually where I like to go. Or it's a good old snapback. And nothing just shows, like, your baldness more than just, like, this little arch. And then I'm always nervous if I get a sunburn.
Oh.
Then I've got, like, this weird, like, sideways D on my head.
I have seen that happen to our friend, the Ted Smith, a couple times.
Nobody wants a sideways D on their bald head.
Well, I just want to challenge you to one day wear your hat backwards so I can see what you're talking
when
about.
When we all go see Limp Bizkit together,
yes.
I will rock the hat backwards.
Okay, I love it.
I'm okay with getting a sideways D on my head at Limp Bizkit.
It would be worth it.
None of that makes sense out of context. Even in context.
Rockaholics, it is time to get informed.
Knowledge is power. So give us five-ish minutes and we'll give you some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daly Migs Download,
a.k.a. the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And the DMD is brought to you by Backwards Hats. No, the DMD is brought to you by Palace Law. Oh, man, when you're thinking about barbecues, what do you think is an essential to put on the grill?
Like, of anything?
Anything.
Well, burgers if you're doing a barbecue.
What if you don't want burgers? What if you want brats?
Okay, you can do brats. It's fine. You can do whatever. Choose your own adventure.
Danny likes the barbecue. What are you going with?
Oh, I'm doing ribs all day.
Ribs. That's a must-have on the grill.
It has to be.
Sarah?
Vegetables?
Do you put them in the tinfoil?
Oh, yeah.
A bunch of, like, crap and then throw it on the grill?
Yeah, well, I don't, but my husband does.
Same. My wife does it.
You know what makes vegetables even better? Meat.
Meat on top of it?
Are you telling me that your wife is the grill master?
No, she prepares the vegetables.
Oh, I thought you had a sexy grill master at home, and I was like,
no,
yes.
No, I'm just out there getting everything ready, and then she just hands me this giant tinfoil ball of vegetables, and I put it on the grill first because it takes forever for them to get all nice and tasty.
What do you like to grill?
The essential? I got to have it with every time that we barbecue. Corn. Corn on the cob, baby.
Corn on the cob is delicious.
It's a must-have. If we don't have corn, we ain't barbecuing. That's the rule in my house.
I like that. Right. Said with confidence.
You know, and maybe this weekend we'll be barbecuing for Father's Day. Father's Day is this Sunday, and you might want to be nicer to your dad, a.k.a. me, a.k.a. Danny.
Yeah.
Reason being, according to a study, they say that you've been slowly killing your father all these years because you basically are giving him added stress, added responsibilities that comes with being a parent. I don't know why it doesn't apply to the moms as well, but according to the study, we're going to go with it. That's what they're saying. So because of you kids, your dads are getting...
They're aging.
Aging quicker than they should. They even say, though, if you have a kid under 20... I mean, if you're a dad at the age of 25 or younger, you're even at a higher risk. So, phew, dodge that bullet.
Danny, sorry about you.
Yeah, so anyways, there you go. Do you already know what you're getting for Father's Day?
No idea.
My daughter's terrible at keeping secrets. The minute they got it in the mail, she gave me my Father's Day gift, which was last week.
Was this the socks?
I now have socks. And I'm not a sock guy, but now I am a sock guy because she bought me, or mom bought it for her, socks with Tatum's face all over them, and they are amazing.
Well, now I know what I'm going to get for Brad. It's a great idea.
Socks with Tatum's face?
No, socks with Bear's face. There's a resort town in Spain that has been well known for rowdy parties, but they have banned public displays of adult inflatables.
This place sounds like Sarah's destination. To a nutshell.
It's called Platea de Oro, and it has become a hotspot for bachelor and bachelorette parties. But of the 12,000 residents in that town, they're not super appreciative of all of this.
But they don't want wiener straws and wiener hats and all the other stuff that come with bachelorette parties?
Blow-up dolls, costumes that resemble male anatomy, all of that has been banned. Visitors are also required to wear clothes in addition to underwear. And then visitors who violate this law will get a fine of up to $1,600. So there was a recent bachelor party that made this rule go into effect because they used tape to tie a groom-to-be to a lamppost and blared loud music.
Well, it seems like an isolated incident. I don't know why you're punishing everybody else because of what this... what kind of friends do you have that tape you to a pole? And then I'm imagining he probably wasn't wearing much.
This sounds like the plot to The
right?
Hangover
yeah.
4 or
yeah.
something like that.
This also answers the question. For the longest time when I was younger, I used to always wonder who are the people that buy these inflatable love toys?
Yeah.
But then it makes sense. They're just gag gifts. Poor choice of words. But they're joke gifts for bachelor and bachelorette parties. Does anyone actually put those things to use?
I'm sure there are people out there, Steve.
Those things are so weird.
They are so weird. And when I was moving recently, there was one under my bed.
Who put it there?
I don't know. Probably me or a friend or something.
What if it was your dad?
Oh, my.
Or
no,
your brother. No, or your brother.
Did you leave it for your dad as a housewarming gift?
No. And to my surprise, George didn't want it either. So we gave it to Goodwill.
What's
I don't know if they're going to want
you
it.
You gave it to Goodwill? Was it opened?
Yeah, it was blown up and everything.
Talking about the mouth? Or
when have you ever been to a Value Village or a Salvation Army where there are blow-up dolls available for purchase? You know they just threw that thing away.
Why did you think that was going to be a good idea?
Also, this would need to be its own section of Goodwill, the secondhand.
Like the old video stores where you went through this weird curtain and that's where all the adult films were.
Yeah.
So at a Value Village, there's a weird curtain and it's a bunch of these?
Yeah, I couldn't throw her away. She was already just looking so surprised, so I just put her in the Goodwill pile.
Newsflash, Goodwill threw her away.
Aww.
There's no chance they resold that thing. There's not a chance in hell. Hey, as far as weather, we're going to hit a high of 75 degrees. Another great day to go check out your Seattle Mariners who are at home taking on the Chicago White Sox. That is the DMD, and that's what's up.
The Daily Migs Show.
206-803-ROCK. We want to know, Rockaholics, what is the stupid thing that you did for love? The reason we're asking is because there's a man in India that took it up a notch. He got caught dressing up as his girlfriend so that he could take an exam for her, which she had already failed once in her quest to become a healthcare worker, which I think I want everyone working in healthcare to have passed all of the tests.
Or at least their boyfriend to pass it for them. Dude, I was reading this story and just seeing some of the pictures and the lengths that he went out of love are insane. I mean, from shaving his whole body to look a certain way and the hair. I think he even forged some documents and voter cards as well.
A fake ID, completely.
Fake ID. And the only way they figured it out, I guess, was from fingerprints.
No way.
That's, I guess, apparently, according to one, it was eventually exposed when his fingerprints failed to match hers on a biometric device.
I didn't realize that was part of the process was fingerprints.
Well, when's the last time you took a test to be a healthcare worker?
Never.
Yeah.
One of the officers involved said a man can only take such a risk for his girlfriend.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's just, he's smitten.
I love that this guy, that the officer's like, I get it, man. So the number to call is 206-803-ROCK. Do you have something dumb that you've done for love?
I mean, I've done a lot of dumb things, I think, but nothing on that level. I've never, like, faked being somebody, but, like, just, like, you know, just buying elaborate gifts, but especially in my 20s. Like, I was spending way too much money trying to, like, you know, like, these crazy, like, floral arrangements. And I'm broken in college, and, like, I can't afford these things, but...
I did a dumb thing for love that I will get a lot of shade for, if I may share it with you.
Yes.
Okay. So when I was now
I'm very curious.
When I was first dating Brad, I mean, this is like brand new. We've barely hung out. There were back-to-back Husky and Seahawks games happening in Seattle. And they were both at the big, you know, football stadium. And so I was like, well, we're going to go to both of these games and it'll be a lot of fun. I don't typically just go to Husky games because I'm a Coug. So... I asked my mom, I'm like, do you have anything like super, you know, under the radar Husky that I could maybe wear? Because I want to like impress this guy. Like, yeah, right. I can root for the Huskies. I don't. I mean, I never do. So I borrowed a Husky, it was like black on black Husky shirt and wore it to the stadium. And I'll never live it down myself. I'm disappointed I did it. I wish I could undo it, but I just wanted him to think I was cool.
Have pictures surfaced of that at
some
point?
Oh, hell no. There's no proof of this at all.
Oh, I was going to say, if there's a picture being taken, do you like zip up your jacket to make sure that nobody sees the Huskies logo?
I mean, I don't even think we took any photos. I think we took them at the Seahawks game the next day, for which I was just decked out in Seahawks gear.
Right, right, right.
But I'm ashamed of my behavior. I would never do it again for love.
I remember one time in college, this was so dumb, but I remember becoming a fan of an artist in a band just because I was hoping it would impress this girl. And it never did.
No.
She was just like, oh, cool, you like this guy too. Do you remember Matthew Sweet?
Nope.
No. Do you remember the song Girlfriend? I need to get back in the arms of girlfriend.
Oh, wow. That's deep. Those are some deep lyrics.
Well, I know, right? It's that kind of work. But, so she was always listening. I'm like, oh, I'm going to like him too. So I went and bought his cassette at the time. And I would like crank it out of my dorm room, hoping that she would hear it. I don't know what I was hoping. Like, she was going to be like, you like Matthew Sweet too? Let's have sex. Like, I don't know why I thought this was going to be impressive to her. And it wasn't. She just thought, oh, cool, you like this guy too. Not a big deal. Yes!
Whoa.
Dude, this song.
Does it slap?
Yeah, shout out to Christine, Hood Hall, Plattsburgh, New York.
It's kind of bluesy. I kind of like it.
Dude, this song is pretty badass. I became a fan of the band eventually, or the artist, but it was only just to try to impress this girl.
How many Matthew Sweet concerts did you go to?
Zero. I mean, I wasn't that... Although he had quite a career... Oh, man, this song just brings me right back to college, man.
I'm waiting for the lyrics to kick in.
He wants to love somebody, Danny.
Have you seen the video for this?
Oh, I'm sure I did multiple times, yeah.
It's like a cartoon.
That's right.
With him singing over it.
Here we go. Here's the hook.
Like a Steve's like...
In the arms of a girlfriend.
Oh, yes. Steve is so happy.
He has not stopped playing air guitar since I started this song.
I could get him to this all morning.
Oh, man.
Come on. This song rips. I'm not doing it for you now.
Ah, dang it.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, it didn't
work. That is so great. I'm glad you did that for love. Became a Matthew Sweet fan.
Became a Matthew Sweet
now
fan.
Now I'm a Matthew Sweet fan. Rockaholics, what's the dumb thing that you did for love? Or what dumb thing did a significant other do for you?
The Daily Migs Show.
What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids do a classroom? Homes.com knows these are all things you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
With an American Standard heat pump system, the future of heating and cooling your home is already here. Bringing constant comfort to your home, American Standard heat pumps are energy efficient, reliable, and ready for tomorrow, today. Plus, making the upgrade from your traditional furnace or AC unit is easier than ever before with home energy offers, rebates, and tax credits. Learn more at AmericanStandardAir.com/electrification. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
Rockaholics, the number to call this morning, or any morning, is 206-803-ROCK. We are asking what stupid thing you did for love, or what dumb thing did a significant other do for you? Steve, you became a fan of a guy, his music.
That's sweet. We were listening to some of it during the break. I was just like, oh, this is one of his other songs. And one texter, he brought up a good point. He's like, please stop. This sounds like a crappy Beatles ripoff band. I'm like, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. But you know what? The dumb things you do for love to try and impress somebody, and it never works out. But one texter said, I went bungee jumping. I'm scared of doing stuff like that. I cried like a little toddler. This was date number two. And my wife, 20 years later, still goose on me about it.
Oh, that's a, I love that story, though.
So at least I said, that would have sucked if like he cried like a little kid, and then
it didn't work out.
And she's just like, yeah, I can't rock with you, man.
You're a baby.
Yeah, he's just a little pansy. Gotta go. So instead, I grew out my hair into a mullet. I hated it at first, but my wife thinks it's hot, LOL, anything to get laid.
Is this recently? Because the mullet is back. So yeah. I don't know if this is like in the 80s or 90s or if this is current mullet.
George, your husband, Sarah, he has a mullet, right?
Oh, yes. And he thinks he's the one that brought it back, actually.
I mean, how do we know that he didn't?
He thinks he's the trendsetter for all the world?
Is there proof that it's not him?
Do not encourage this, Darren.
Okay, but Sarah, I have been asking Brad when he does decide to cut his hair, because he's been growing out his hair for like almost 4 years probably now. And he's only had a couple trims here and there, but I've been asking him to cut a mullet before he actually cuts his hair.
Oh. Will he?
Yeah, I hope so. Like, I would like him to just try the mullet for like a day or two.
Uh-huh.
And then he can cut it however he wants. But I'm like, you gotta just rock a mullet for a couple days,
oh,
right?
Man. I try to convince my wife to let me grow a skullet. And she's just like, if you want to ever be kissed by me or any kind of affection, even a hug, you're not getting any of that if you grow a skullet out.
Have you, you should just practice or just like try it out with a skullet wig. I mean, they have to make those.
Oh, I wonder if I could get somebody to do it for me and then come home one day and just be like, work had this hair implant company that wanted to work with me. I wanted to stay true to me, so I didn't have them put any hair up here.
Implants in the back.
Yes.
Party on the top.
No, I'd rock the bandana, and then, you know, when times get crazy, then you take the bandana off.
What do you think is underneath Bret Michaels' bandana and cowboy hat? What do you think's happening under there?
A lack of hair.
Do you think it's a skullet, though?
I wouldn't be surprised if there's maybe some kind of like a hair implant going on with Bret Michaels.
Okay.
I don't know. I mean, who knows? Somebody texted in that said, hey, Steve, don't feel bad. I did the same thing for a girl. I was 10 years old, and it was the new kids on the block, though, so it was embarrassing.
Jeremy in Silverdale, you wore a costume. What was the costume?
It was a pink inflatable unicorn costume.
Yes.
At Boston International Airport.
Oh, my goodness.
So were you waiting, like, in the luggage area, waiting for your girl to show up?
Oh, yeah. And I went to the wrong terminal initially, so that was awesome. So I had to wait for that little transit bus that brings you around.
Yeah.
And as I'm waiting, people are driving up and, you know, laughing, but they were, like, loving it. One lady had asked if she could take pictures, you know, with her kids and stuff. So I was posing for pictures with people. It was crazy. And when I got to the correct terminal, my girl was just like, just shocked but laughing. And she's like, take that damn thing off your face.
Did you get stopped by anyone like from like security, like TSA, saying, hey, sir, what are you doing here?
No, but they had some really like interesting looks, obviously. But when I asked them, you know, what terminal I should be in, they were like, oh, you're just an idiot. I get it.
Well, right on, Jeremy. Thanks for the call. Somebody said last summer my coworker did cut his hair into a giant mullet. His long hair into a mullet is a joke before cutting it all the way, but his wife loved it, so he still has it today.
Okay, now I feel like Brad needs to do this for love for me.
I think I could see Brad rocking a mullet.
I might have to make this happen, like today or this week.
I mean, very impulsive. I mean, okay, you have to make it happen.
I'm going to remind him that I wore a Husky shirt for him, and now it's time to pay it back.
Danny, have you done anything? I feel like you probably have done some stupid things just out of love.
I mean, yeah, it's the music thing. For me, it was like going to many different concerts where I'm just like not a fan of the music at all. I'm pretending to like it. And then years later, just being like, you know what? No, I absolutely – something corporate. That band, for some reason, I just hated that band for the longest time, but I pretended to like it for my ex-wife. And then finally, I was just, you know, I don't really like something corporate. Ironically enough, I ended up liking it after we got divorced.
That band got me so stoned once at one of their shows that I physically could not walk.
Oh, yeah.
They had one of those, like, these, like, on their tour bus. I remember I was working at the end. I was in my 20s at the time. And I went on there, and like, you want a hit of this, like, gravity bong thing?
Yes.
It's like this inflatable thing. I'm like, yeah, let's party. And I took one hit, and I just sat down, and I go, I can't get up. And they're like, well, we have to go. So either you're going with us to, like, Portland, or like, I'll make an effort. And I, like stumbled down the steps of the tour bus. And I remember my buddy had, like, basically carried me back to my apartment in Queen Anne. Because I was just like, I can't walk.
Can't kick it with that band anymore.
No, it was insane.
The Daily Migs Show.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
With an American Standard heat pump system, the future of heating and cooling your home is already here. Bringing constant comfort to your home, American Standard heat pumps are energy efficient, reliable, and ready for tomorrow, today. Plus, making the upgrade from your traditional furnace or AC unit is easier than ever before with home energy offers, rebates, and tax credits. Learn more at AmericanStandardAir.com/electrification. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
The Daily Migs Show is inviting you to come out to the ball game. The Everett Aqua Sox game happening on July 21st, to be exact. It's a Sunday, and tickets are on sale now if you head to KISW.com. We're going to be sitting in, I believe it's Section M for Migs. And it would be so rad if you would come and join us. Bring the whole family. All the info at KISW.com.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs. Don't be a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs? I know Alan from Seattle is. Alan, are you there?
I'm ready.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
See ya.
Alan sounds like a winner to me.
Yes, we're rooting for you. For those playing at home, Alan has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. What actor recently pleaded not guilty to a manslaughter charge in the filming of the movie Rust?
Alec Baldwin.
Yes. Which is the only vowel on a standard keyboard that is not on the top line of letters?
U.
No.
A.
Yes. What English rock band headlined the Super Bowl in 2010?
The Rolling Stones.
No.
Pass.
Where does Peter Pan live?
Neverland.
Yes. How many claws does a domestic cat usually have?
5.
No.
6.
No.
4.
No. In the TV show Breaking Bad, what is the name of Walter White's alter ego?
Heisenberg.
Yes. Which girl group gave us the hits Waterfalls and No Scrubs?
TLC.
Yes. How many blank tiles are there in Scrabble?
10.
No.
12.
No.
15.
No. Hot dogs are said to have originated in what country?
America.
No.
Germany.
Yes. Which planet has the shortest orbit?
Mercury.
Yes. What? And with that, you get 7 correct, Alan.
Alan, my man.
Yeah, that's pretty dang good. I feel like Steve might know 1 or 2 that he didn't, but maybe it'll be the other way around, too. So hopefully not another tie.
Oh, great.
Oh,
Taryn's
Steve.
Got the look.
I'm believing in Alan right now.
I know, you're giving me that look like you are so dumb.
Steve, are you ready?
Oh, yes.
What actor recently pleaded not guilty to a manslaughter charge in the filming of the movie Rust?
Alec Baldwin.
Yes. Which is the only vowel on a standard keyboard that is not on the top line of letters?
I'm going to go Y.
No.
You?
No.
I.
No. What English rock band headlined the Super Bowl in 2010?
You too.
No.
Coldplay?
No.
English rock band. Oasis?
No. Where does Peter Pan live?
He lives in Tukwila.
No.
He lives in Puyallup?
No.
He lives in Never Neverland.
No.
The Neverland Forest. Ah,
how many claws does a domestic cat usually have?
How many claws? 5?
No.
6?
No.
4?
No. In the TV show Breaking Bad, what is the name of Walter White's alter ego?
Heisenberg.
Yes. Which girl group gave us the hits Waterfalls and No Scrubs?
TLC.
Correct. How many blank tiles are there in Scrabble?
Rest in peace, Left Eye. 4?
No.
5?
No.
8?
No. Hot dogs are said to have originated in what country?
Canada.
No.
America?
No. Wow, Steve.
Oh, not good.
You got 3 correct, which is a big loss, 7-3.
Oh,
yeah.
I had way more faith in you, Steve. I'm so sorry, Alan, because you killed it.
I'm not sorry. You're welcome, Steve.
Yeah, baby.
Thanks, Alan.
And you said Never Neverland. It was just Neverland.
Oh.
So maybe you got 4. I don't know. I don't want to get it to you.
It wouldn't have mattered.
It really wouldn't have.
It would have. It would have changed the entire trajectory course of this entire game.
Oh, really? Because you didn't know the only vowel on a standard keyboard that is not on the top line of letters is A? Right,
you know, there. I was going to guess that, and I was like, there's no way it's A.
It is.
Yeah.
What English rock band headlined the Super Bowl in 2010? Does anyone know?
No idea.
You too. No. I guess you too.
And oh, I would have guessed Rolling Stones, and that's what Alan guessed.
The Who. There we go.
Oh.
Yeah. I knew all my guesses were wrong, but I could not think of any other artist.
You couldn't.
No.
How many claws does a domestic cat usually have?
Is it saying like on total
all
on
of that?
So is it 10?
No.
Is it 12?
It's 18.
18?
They got a lot of claws.
That's scary.
And I think you and Alan were both thinking I just meant like one paw.
Yeah.
No, yeah, I meant.
And then I guess four, because I was like, maybe this is a trick question and claws are just paws. So I was like, well, they have four of them. I don't know.
That's not what
that's how my brain. That's how my brain was working at that point. I'm like, I don't know anymore.
I'm bad at this game.
There are only two blank tiles in the game of Scrabble.
Really?
I don't remember the last time I ever played, even played Scrabble. It has to be over 20 years.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
I bet you'll play it with Tatum when, you know, when our kids are starting to read and stuff. I feel like Scrabble will be a good game for our kids to learn.
All right.
Educational.
I mean, yeah.
I don't think you two, no offense, would be good at Scrabble or teaching your kids.
Oh,
like,
my gosh. Okay, you know what we're going to do at Chuck E. Cheese? We're going to have a crazy game of Scrabble. It's going to be a Scrabble tournament. And Sarah, I'm going to whoop ass.
Karen, we want people to come to this party. I don't know if Scrabble is the way to get people to
have
show
up. A real intense Scrabble tournament.
Definitely not. And hot dogs, one that he did correct that you didn't.
Germany?
Yes. So you would have done a little better, but still wouldn't have
Frankfurt.
Won.
Frankfurt.
Yeah, no, no, yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, that's solid. I did not do well. Not every game's going to be a great game.
The Daily Migs Show.
Who doesn't love a little concert drama, Steve Migs?
Yes.
Richard Marx was doing a show when a woman decided to yell something out. And it was during one of his acoustic songs.
Did she yell, "Why am I at a Richard Marx concert?" What was his song? I'll be right here waiting for you.
That maybe. Well, then didn't
you guys don't know it? No. Am I the only Richard Marx enthusiast in this room?
I'll be honest with you. I didn't even know Richard Marx was a musician. I thought that was like the guy that wrote something weird.
You don't know Richard Marx?
No.
Oh my gosh.
Didn't he co-write, God, what is the song? Dance with My Father?
I don't know what the hell that is.
Yeah, I think he won a Grammy for that. But no, I'm not a Richard Marx fan personally. Oh.
This song? Come on, this was a banger.
Oh, look at that mullet.
You don't know this, Danny? No.
Wasn't it in Robin Hood?
No, I think that was like a Bryan Adams song.
Oh. Maybe it was a cover of this song.
They kind of had the same voice.
They totally do.
What is happening?
This has to be in a movie soundtrack, though.
Come on.
No.
I think he was like a rocker dude, too, before that. And then he realized, I'll make way more money if I sing these
kind
of
slow
songs.
Jams.
Yeah.
Yeah. And there was a woman that yelled something out during one of his acoustic songs. We have the audio. What did she even say?
I don't know.
I think she said, play right here waiting for you. I don't know. Yeah. Did she just have an involuntary moment of just like, where's the bathroom?
Well, so Richard Marx waited until that song was over. Then he went off on her.
I'm genuinely curious who raised you to think that anything you could yell out was more important than what we were doing. Learn some manners, ladies.
Yes. See, he's got an edge.
Throwing in F-bombs.
He's like Mr. Chill, love song guy. He's like, learn some effing manners.
I did look up a picture of him now. He's like 60. He looks great.
Yeah. Yeah, he's aged okay. I remember seeing a picture of him recently. And
he's moisturizes, probably.
I'm just not happy he doesn't have that same mullet.
That mullet is sick. I mean, look how fluffy and feathered that is.
Have you ever...
I would want to chew on his knuckles while running my fingers through his hair.
You just ruined Steve's excitement. Whatever you do, you better not chew on my knuckles, T-Dog. Dude, it just made me think of a time. I don't know if you guys have ever been with somebody where they like to yell in like a concert or, well, concert people yell. But I'm thinking about, I remember one time it was a stand-up comedy show. And I had the worst experience of my life. And it was like one of those things where I felt like I could do nothing about it. Because I've been in situations where I've been with a girlfriend in the past where they've decided just to yell something during a comedy show. I'm like, what are you doing? Like, don't be that person. Don't be the heckler. Don't even be the person that's like agreeing with the comic loudly. Like, let them do their show and let's just laugh and have a good time. And I was dating somebody, and it was around the time when Kyle Cease was crushing it in comedy. Like, mm-hmm. He's now moved. He's morphed more into like doing like positive
affirmation talk, like Tony Robbins type stuff and things along those lines, and he's killing it in that as well. But at the time, he was just doing stand-up. He was a local dude that had grown on, gone on to do some big things. He was in 10 Things I Hate About You, I think it was. And he was doing a show at the Moore Theater, and it was being recorded for Comedy Central for a special. So it was a big deal for him, right? And so he hit us up, and he's like, hey, would you guys introduce me on stage? I'm like, absolutely. Thank you for the opportunity. So we got to go introduce him on stage and then hang on the side of the stage for the whole set. But I got tickets for my then-girlfriend at the time, who's now an ex, and this is one of maybe a few reasons why. And she took one of her friends, and I didn't think anything of it. So I'm watching the show, and all of a sudden this person is yelling during the show, like communicating with Kyle like as if he's only telling jokes to her.
So quick question. Were you side stage and she's in the crowd?
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm hearing this, and even all of us on the side, which wasn't many of us, but it was a couple people, it's his person that's helping produce and things, and we're like, this woman just shut the F up. Like, the whole time, we're like, just shut up. And then one moment, it finally clicked. I'm like, wait a second, that voice is familiar.
No.
And then I realized, this is my girlfriend.
Heckling.
I don't even know if she's heckling. She's just engaging and wanting to kind of a conversation. And Kyle handled it great. It was super funny. It ended up in the Comedy Central special because of what he was saying to her. Like, this whole thing. But all I'm thinking is, I have no way to get her to stop this. You know, I can't tell her to be quiet because I'm on the side of the stage. I can't come barreling out the door and be like, you shut up. Like, I don't want to make any kind of scene.
Do you think her friend was embarrassed?
No. They were wasted having the time in their life. So the show ends, and I'm kind of like, keep cool. Like, don't, you're going to have a conversation with her, but like, don't let it bother you. And they come up, and they're just glowing. And they're like, did you hear the person that was yelling in the crowd? And I'm like, yeah, that was me. I'm like, I'm aware of that. And I was just like, what is wrong with you?
That's mortifying.
And we had a big argument about it, because I'm thinking, how did you not think this was a good idea? And then the worst thing that could happen was he put it in the Comedy Central special. Understandable, because he handled it like, of course, like a pro would, and it was very funny. But I'm just like, great, this is just the moment that I get to relive. And it almost justified in her head what she did was good, because she gave him this great moment. I'm like, you know he would have had a great special without you. Well, it's not like as if you made the special any better.
The Daily Migs Show.
What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids do a classroom? Homes.com knows these are all things you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
206-803-ROCK. We're asking you, Rockaholics, what is something you have never done that surprises people when they find out? One for me, I've still never had a Whopper or a Big Mac.
Yeah, we're going to make
two for me.
We're going to change that.
Yeah.
I don't know when, but at some point we're going to change that.
What time do they start serving that?
Well, 10, I think. Okay. 10-ish, 10:30 maybe. 10:30. I don't know. I don't know if Burger King just does it all around the clock, but I know from McDonald's, your Big Mac, you have to wait until I think sometime after 10:30.
Okay. All right.
And then Whoppers, man. You're missing out.
Okay.
Hey, the texts are coming in at 206-803-ROCK. Somebody just texted said, I never rode a bike. I'm 39 years old.
You should join my Bike MS team. It's going to be awesome.
When's that happening?
September, like 7th, 8th, 9th in there.
Okay, so they got
so
a good
got plenty of time.
8 months to learn how to ride a bicycle.
I'll teach you. I'm still an amateur cyclist. I'll teach you.
Wait, you're willing to teach some random person how to ride a bicycle?
Yes.
In. I want to see this. I know how to ride a bike.
Have you ever clipped your feet into the into the clip-in pedals before?
On one of stationary bike ones. But
okay, cool.
I don't like that. I don't like knowing that if I go, I'm stuck on this thing.
You don't like being one with the bike?
No. I don't
want to
be one. I want to separate with that bike if I'm falling. I want to go.
You just have to learn how to unclick your feet, and then you can.
At that point in time, I'm not going to be thinking about, okay, unclick my feet. I'm going to be screaming an F word and trying not to land on my face.
All right. So yeah. No clip-ins for Steve.
No, that's fine. I never liked on the boogie boards or on the surfboards where you have to Velcro it onto your foot. I'm like, no, I want to just I want a clean exit.
But then you're going to lose your board. And those are expensive.
I probably rented it at that point. So you know what? They got my security deposit. I don't know, man. I've been trying to teach Tatum how to ride a bike. That's been an adventure.
Oh. Barrett doesn't really have an interest in anything other than the Strider bike.
She wasn't feeling that. She doesn't she likes to sit on her bike. The whole pedaling thing is just it's a nightmare.
Oh yeah.
Do you have one of those balance bikes without the pedals?
The Strider bike.
Oh, that's right.
Is that what that is? Right. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I know. Okay.
Yeah. They just sit on it. That did nothing for her. She likes the scooters. She's a scooting queen right there. Like she's flying around on that scooter. But once we try the bicycle, it's just paralyzed. And I was trying to think of what tips did I get? And I honestly can't remember who taught me how to ride my bike. I'm assuming it was my dad, and I assumed that he was cursing the whole way.
I think my experience was probably the same.
Yeah, if it was anything like him trying to teach me how to drive a car, that did not go well.
Did you learn it on a stick or on a...
No, I learned on a chair. No, I'm kidding. No, it was just a regular. It wasn't a stick.
It was an automatic.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And
it
was a nightmare. He freaked out. He was yelling at me. And then I was like, I'm never doing this again. I had my buddy Andy in college teach me actually how to drive a car.
I mean, I rode with you yesterday. I think you should keep learning.
Oh, yeah? Is that what it is?
Continued education.
Wow.
I'm joking. You're a great driver, Steve.
We're surprised to find out that Steve still doesn't know how to drive a car.
I don't. I just, I just kind of go where I go.
We're asking the question, Rockaholics, what is something you have never done that surprises people when they find out? 206-803-ROCK.
No, the text just said sex. 35 years old, have not gotten laid yet.
Okay, let's get together. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, you're going to teach them how to
do that? I'm going to teach that guy how to ride a bike.
And this guy
ride. This guy how to sex.
Okay, how to sex. Are you going to help this lady get pierced? Because she has never been pierced. She's 40 years old.
Oh, my gosh.
And that actually is kind of surprising.
I will go get a piercing with you.
Sid has brought up, hey, what do you think about getting Tatum's ears pierced? I'm like, well, no. I have
what?
No. I mean, if she really wants it, go ahead. Don't bring me. I don't know if I can handle watching
you think
that.
You might pass out?
Well, I passed out when I got pierced.
Oh, my God. I forgot about that.
So you don't think I'm going to pass out watching my daughter get pierced?
That was your eyebrow, right?
Yeah, yeah. That would definitely happen. That was pretty bad. I don't think I have it anymore. Oh, wow.
That video was... It's terrifying.
I feel really lightheaded right now. I might pass out. Yeah, I'm gonna pass out, dude.
Whoa!
Yeah, there's no way I want to watch my daughter get pierced.
No. Back in the day, I had 17 piercings all at the same time.
What? 17?
17.
All on the ears?
No. No.
What?
Do I...
Yes!
I want to know. Oh, I want to know. Ask the question.
Hold on. Can you please sign this waiver from HR? Where else were these piercings?
Not in my ears. I had my belly button pierced.
Okay. Did you have the little, you know how some people have,
a little dangly?
Clever, like a zipper?
Oh, gosh. I don't remember all the stupid belly
or a little
button.
Unicorn?
Yeah, I had a lot of different.
A peace sign? I see you as a peace sign kind of.
I probably did have a peace sign.
Yeah, I could see that.
And that. These.
Oh!
My eyes are up here, Taryn. I do not look down below your neck.
That was a long time ago when I was very rebellious.
You had both of those?
Yeah. I was very rebellious. I had turned 18 and I was like, Mom and Dad, I'm doing whatever I want.
Did you have a chain going from it to your nose?
No, I never had any piercings in my face. Just
really?
My ears.
No nose, no eyebrow.
Nope. I had one of my sisters did the eyebrow thing. But I don't.
Oh, college.
Never
that
did the
was...
tongue.
That would make you from a five in your eyes of attractiveness to a 10. If a girl had the nose ring.
Oh, and then, but the nose ring with the chain to the ear.
Oh, then forget about it.
The Daily Migs Show.
Rockaholics, what was your ultimate lie? Something you made up that everyone believed, like the wedding vows I said at my first wedding. 206-803-ROCK.
I mean, it was a long, that was a very long lie. How long did that marriage last?
4 years.
A 4-year lie. Look at you. Oh, yeah, Danny lied as well. How many years?
4 years as well.
It was the 4-year itch.
Some people have to have a starter marriage. I feel that in my heart.
Or is it 7-year itch, but 4-year bitch? Like, bitch, I'm leaving you? No.
Something you made up that everyone believed, Rockaholics. 206-803-ROCK. Davey and Edmonds, you told everyone your name was Axl Rose.
Yes, my uncle bought me their album, like, 86 or whatever, and he said, check out this guy's name. His name's Axl Rose. I'm like, oh, that really rung with me. So all my friends, when I was in seventh grade, when I moved into the new neighborhood, I told them my name was Axl Rose.
Very random.
How long did you get to keep that lie up?
Probably maybe 3 weeks until all the parents were saying, your friend's name's Axl Rose? That's a lie. That's not true. That's not a thing.
And plus, so, you didn't go with the W Axl Rose, like, you know, because originally it was W.
Oh, yeah.
And I always thought that was so bad. It's like, then you spell it out and it says war. It's like, he's such a badass.
William Axl Rose.
Yeah.
Joe and Stanwood, you went to a bar and told everyone you were a professional baseball player.
Oh, yeah.
Was it a bar in Stanwood?
Yeah. No. I was down at the Hard Rock in Seattle. And it was during the 2002 when we had the All-Star game in Seattle. And a bunch of the ball players, celebrities, were hanging out in a VIP room down at the Hard Rock.
Okay.
So when I entered, I told them, hi, I'm Joe blank blank. I'm a pitcher from the Anaheim Angels. So they bring two models over, and they escort me into a room and have me give my signature, which I do. Then they escort me downstairs into the VIP room, and I'm sitting there with Kemp and Peyton and a bunch of the Seahawks, Cortez Kennedy, just celebrities everywhere.
And
so I'm eating all night for free and drinking all night for free, and they think I'm some, you know, professional ball player, and just had a wild night.
So are you built very much like an athlete, or were you at the time?
I am. I'm 6'2". I look like a pitcher.
And so at no point, nobody was just like, wait a second, your name doesn't sound familiar. Or was it like one of those situations where, like, I don't want to be the guy that says I don't believe him, but what if he's telling the truth, then I look like the jerk?
No, I told him I'm a backup pitcher, so, you know, I'm not, you don't see me very often, you know. I'm on the bench a lot.
But when you're needed, you come through.
But you know what?
Right. In a pinch, I come through. You know, that's the deal.
That's amazing, dude. Good on you for being able to pull that off and stick. I would be a nervous wreck once I saw all the actual celebrities.
For sure.
Well, you know, I think because of the age I was back then, I was so cocky that I actually tried to believe it myself. So then I made the lie even better, you know.
I love that they brought a couple of models too. They're just like, here, let's bring them.
Right.
That's amazing.
That's celebrity status for sure.
You should have tried the same thing for the backup goalie for the NHL All-Star game, Steve.
There's still time.
Or the Winter Classic. I just show up. I'm like, I'm the emergency backup goalie, Stevie E-Bug. where are my models and where is my chicken wings?
Osh in Everett, what did you tell a bunch of strippers?
So probably about 20 years ago, my buddy's getting married. So we do a bachelor party down in Portland. I may or may not have taken a work van and loaded it up with 10 guys and headed down there.
Nice.
We get down there, and then I told some of the dancers that we were a team of underwater welders doing a job at the port. And we were making about $200 an hour doing with hazard pay at OT. So they figured that me and all my guys were loaded with money and basically hung out with us all night long because they thought we were loaded.
So did you make it worth their while?
Oh, yeah. We saw money. So here's the funniest thing, too, about it. It's the first time I actually saw there was one of the dancers got into a fight with the manager, went on stage, and started just basically throwing a tantrum.
Awesome.
So me and one of my other guys just started just throwing down money like crazy. And it's the first time I've ever seen a stripper get fired and hauled off the stage and kicked out of the club.
Dude, I would make it rain on that person,
too.
That
is worth the price of admission right there.
So that was the thing. So me and my buddy are just dropping money down.
Yeah.
He gets kicked off the stage, gets fired, gets thrown out of the club. So we just picked up all our money and took it back.
Oh, wow.
Oh, and did you follow her out and give it to her?
No, she was gone. She was escorted out by security. So,
dude, I never thought, like, if I'm a stripper, which that's, try not to laugh already, but if I was a stripper, I would work out a scam with the boss and be like, fire me on stage. I'll get the sympathy and get a bunch of money, and then I'll just sit out for like, you know, an hour, and I'll come back in and then fire me again. Like, that's
your strategy.
That's my strategy to make more money.
I like it. That's a good business model.
At the end of each night, fire me, and then I'll get some extra money on my way out, and then I'll be back tomorrow. I got rehired.
The Daily Migs Show.
What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids do a classroom? Homes.com knows these are all things you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law. This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
It would be the perfect time to hook yourself up with some Halloween hullabaloo tickets. That is going to be happening on October 13th at the Showwear Center in Kent. On the bill, we've got Godsmack and Hailstorm, and we highly encourage you to dress up in some sort of a costume. I don't know, maybe we should do a group costume here on the Daily Migs Show.
I suggest we should dress up as zebras.
Great. You know what? What about white tigers?
Oh, even better.
Get your tickets and all the info at KISW.com.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play B-Migs.
B-Migs, don't be a loser. B-Migs, you're a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs? I know Dustin from Bellevue is. Dustin, are you there?
I am here.
I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Dustin has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready? What is the name of the TV series that followed the survivors of a plane crash on a mysterious island?
Lost.
Correct. What month is Black History Month?
February.
Yes. How many colors will you find in a regular bag of M&Ms?
Four.
No.
Five.
No.
Six.
Yes. Megan Thee Stallion is currently feuding with what other female rapper?
Pass.
In the Zodiac, what is the sign directly opposite of Scorpio?
Cancer.
No.
Sagittarius.
No.
Pisces.
No. What company has used the slogan, Think Different?
Apple.
Yes.
Microsoft.
What science fiction classic stars Linda Hamilton as Sarah Connor?
Terminator.
Correct. What U.S. state has the only non-rectangular flag?
Texas.
No.
Hawaii.
No.
Alaska.
No. According to Greek mythology, who was the first woman on Earth?
Athena.
No. Dustin, you got 5 correct, though. Kind of right down the middle.
I think I probably would have been right there with Dustin with 5.
Around 5?
Yeah.
Yeah? I think Steve is going to have this one. I'm predicting it.
Sarah's pulling for you, Steve.
Atta girl.
She believes.
I believe in you.
It's about damn time.
Steve, are you ready?
Yes.
What is the name of the TV series that followed the survivors of a plane crash on a mysterious island?
Lost.
Correct. What month is Black History Month?
Our month right now. February.
Yes. How many colors will you find in a regular bag of M&Ms?
4?
No.
5?
No.
6?
Yes. Megan Thee Stallion is currently feuding with what other female rapper?
Cardi B?
No.
What's the other one? Oh, crap. I can't think of a song. Oh, man. Dua Lipa.
No.
I don't know. SZA.
No. In the Zodiac, what is the sign directly opposite of Scorpio?
Aquarius.
No.
Libra.
No.
Virgo.
No. What company has used the slogan, Think Different?
Oh. Apple?
Yes. What science fiction classic stars Linda Hamilton as Sarah Connor?
Your clothes, give them to me. Terminator.
Yes. What U.S. state has the only non-rectangular flag?
Washington?
No.
Alaska?
No.
Hawaii?
No. According to Greek mythology, who was the first woman on Earth?
Megan Thee Stallion.
No.
Taryn Daly.
No.
Venus.
No. And without knowing that, you got 5 correct, which is a tie. Another tie.
Is it Nicki Minaj?
Yes, it is.
I was like, okay, Cardi B, or I couldn't think of, because those were like two artists. I remember they were super popular around the same time. And I'm like, oh my gosh.
Yes. And some people Nicki think they sound similar. And yeah. But Megan Thee Stallion is feuding with Nicki. Mm. It's a whole thing.
I know. I haven't been able to sleep about it.
Right?
I'm today years old that they're having any.
Oh, they are.
Do you know what the beef is about?
One of them put something in their song that was kind of dissing the other one and the other one's relationship. And, you know.
Yeah. Come on, ladies. Yeah. Let's not tear each other down. Let's build each other up.
Right?
We're better than this.
Isn't that what we're supposed
are
to
we?
Do?
Are we?
I know we're not.
Clearly no. Not. In the Zodiac, what sign is directly opposite of Scorpio?
Taurus?
Yes.
Oh!
Okay, Taryn.
Taryn making it happen.
And then the U.S. state has the only non-rectangular flag is
it something on the East Coast?
It's Ohio.
Oh, no.
I like how you're like, I'm not even going to play this game.
No.
With you.
What was the other one? What was the
Greek mythology?
Yeah.
First woman.
I don't know.
She has a box.
So do I.
Pandora.
There we go. Oh.
So do I. It was just said by Taryn.
Well, Steve did guess you, Taryn. So
I did.
I guess he was kind of close.
Woo!
The Daily Migs Show.
Entertainment Weekly put together a list of the best good boys and girls from movies and TV. Of course, we're talking about the best dogs ever.
Might be the most important article that Entertainment Weekly has ever done in the eyes of Taryn Daly.
I love a pup. I'm a dog person.
Ooh.
No disrespect to the cats, but I am a dog person.
What would be your number one? If you had to pick a number one.
I mean, that's tough. Like, I feel like I grew up watching a lot of Lassie reruns and always thought Lassie was so cool.
I mean, he was a lifesaver.
I mean, I always, like, wonder if my dogs have any abilities to do Lassie work.
Well, I'm positive my dogs can. I mean, well, Lulu's blind and has no teeth, so she'll just keep walking into a wall.
Oh. There, I mean, this list has some good ones, though. I'm actually kind of shocked. I'm just going to kind of cherry pick in here. They put Snoopy from Peanuts at number 15.
How's that not number one?
I don't know.
Snoopy's the goat.
Yeah. I mean, he's a dog. Okay.
So that one, I wish I had like some kind of like foam hand so I could slap you but not get in trouble for slapping you with a foam hand as opposed to my actual hand.
Another one that should probably, I think, should be a little closer to the top of the list, Toto from The Wizard of Oz, just for like general, you know, recognizability.
Oh, all right, so I'm now currently looking at this list, and I'm sorry, this list is all trash.
Wow.
Okay, but number one on the list.
This list doesn't matter. My number one is not even on this
list. Who's your number one?
It's a no-brainer. It's the greatest dog of all time. Save Christmas.
Huh? Are you talking about Max from The Grinch?
Max is the best freaking dog in all.
Because he did save Christmas.
Without Max, Grinch would still be a douche.
That's true. He put that horn on his head.
How do you have, I mean, I don't know who the hell is Jack.
Or was it Antler?
Who the hell is Jack from The Artist?
I don't know who Jack from The Artist is. Milo from The Mask is pretty cute.
Yeah, no Max.
But they put, number one is actually two dogs.
Who
so
the
that's
hell are they?
Chance and Shadow from Homeward Bound. Yeah. Steve, your homework assignment for this weekend is to watch Homeward Bound, The Incredible Journey.
Oh, Tatum will love it.
Is this a movie?
Yes. It's very emotional. There's also a cat named, is it Sassy?
Sassy, yeah.
Wait, if it's emotional, I'm not watching it.
It's kind of.
I'm going to just watch The Grinch with Max.
What's the kid's name?
Oh, I don't remember that.
Peter, my boy. Peter.
Yeah.
Does this movie end sad?
No, it doesn't end sad.
No, it ends actually very happy.
Okay.
Cujo is not on this list.
Why isn't Marley from Marley and Me on this list?
Why isn't Ren from Ren and Stimpy on this list?
Does this list need to have dogs that are still alive? That seems kind of ridiculous. Spoiler alert, if you haven't seen Marley and Me.
Oh, stop.
That one.
That is the saddest movie of all time.
Where is Zero from The Nightmare Before Christmas?
Oh my gosh, that's a great call. Doesn't make the list of, doesn't make the top 20. Oh. Buddy from Air Bud is in here.
Yeah!
What about Bluey?
Bluey is not on
the entire cast of Bluey.
We mentioned Toy Story earlier. Slinky from the Toy Story movie.
Aren't they dingoes?
Who?
From no, Bluey? I think they're cattle dogs.
Blue? No, from oh, are they?
No, I think Bluey, they're cattle dogs.
They're dogs.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I don't know. Some kind of. I don't remember.
I mean,
what
isn't
kind.
A dingo a dog? Though.
I'm not from Australia, Taryn. I don't know.
Oh, Beethoven from Beethoven.
Oh yeah.
What's the dog that would go around with like the little canister of like? That's St. Bernard.
That's Beethoven.
Beethoven. Okay, yeah. Beethoven.
Good job, Steve.
I had a brain fart for a second. I thought, yeah, it's an Australian cattle dog. It's blue.
Oh, they're so cute.
Yeah, but they don't look anything like the cartoon.
Well, no, because he's blue. That's very unrealistic.
When are we going to get this foam hand made? I need it. I'm going to need it, I feel like, for a lot of parts of this show.
What was the other one on this list? Oh, Mickey Mouse's pet Pluto.
Oh, yeah.
That should also be in the top, I think.
Oh, speaking of which, Tatum's not happy with you, my daughter.
What did I do?
She heard the clip of you saying that Goofy is a cow.
I'm still the person that voiced Goofy said that Goofy was not a dog.
Right. So you said that Goofy's a cow and that Goofy's not a dog.
I'm standing by this.
And I was listening to a clip at home, and she overheard that, and we had to record a video to send to the show. To tell you that Goofy is not a dog.
Are you going to shame me?
I mean, not
me?
A cow. Well, I'm not, but Tatum is. And this is what she had to say.
Goofy's not the cow. Mirabel is. Pluto's not the cow. Oh, Donald. Oh, Daisy.
Just in case you were wondering.
She knows all the characters.
Yeah.
And which ones are not cows.
There you go. Just quit being stupid.
I'm
just going to go home now. Hang my head in shame.
Like, of all things she overhears that she needs to like, chime in on, it was that.
Well, she would be the expert out of all of us.
That is true.
Yeah.
These kids are spending the most amount of time with these characters.
So who's Porkchop from Doug?
Oh, Porkchop was the best!
Porkchop was. That was a quail dog.
Yeah.
Sarah, you know that one?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
And then, the other one that was in there. Wasn't there another one?
I saw Santa's Little Helper from The Simpsons was in there, and that's a good pick.
Spike from Rugrats.
Oh, that's a good.
Again,
one.
Like that was just the dog on Rugrats. I don't feel like he had a lot of like cultural significance.
I'm with this texter. I like how they even said it. I can't even say what they said on the radio, so I'll paraphrase. But they said, "Hey, where the F is Scooby-Doo? I mean, Scrappy-Doo, you can stay off."
That is This list is trash.
No Scooby. No Max. You know what? I know people hate on Scrappy. I still like Scrappy, too.
I mean, this. Now that I'm looking back through, this is kind of crazy.
What about Tiger from the Brady Bunch?
Steve, I don't remember that show because you're older than me.
Man.
I am going online right now, and I'm ordering a foam hand.
The Daily Migs Show.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
We are heading to the Everett Aqua Sox game, and we want you to join us, Rockaholics. The Daily Migs Show is going to be at the game on Sunday, July 21st. I think it's a 4:05 first pitch. And I am so excited. We're going to be in Section M, as in Migs.
Yes, or Mariners.
That too.
Yeah.
I love
that. That's their parent team right there, baby.
Get your tickets. Get all the info at KISW.com.
Everyone knows social media is a time suck. And what you're about to hear proves it. If it's online, someone, somewhere has an opinion and is whining about it. So let's get straight to the comments.
There is a vegan bakery on Long Island under investigation for allegedly reselling donuts that were purchased at Dunkin'.
Oh, this should go well.
This happened about a month ago, but recent social media posts have surfaced about this kerfuffle. Some were very angry about this happening, so of course we have to go straight to the comments.
Yes, we came across a few social media posts and some other stuff as well online about this story and sent them to our buddy, our production director, Jason, a.k.a. Veggie Dog, a.k.a. VD, so that he could pull some of his favorite comments and reenact them in whatever voice he wants. Just point out just how crazy people get on social media, especially when you use the term vegan.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Very polarizing, as I know all too well. Some people just want to tell you what they think, even though I don't care what you do.
Yeah.
Either way, do whatever you want.
Live
but on the flip side, there are also some vegans that do want to tell you everything what to do. So I can understand some vegans have kind of earned the backlash.
Sure.
But this one starts off with a little, how do I say it? I guess a statement from Jason before he even goes into it, which I think is just great. He says, I needed to get something off my chest first. So we're going to go straight to the comments with Jason, our production director.
Let me just say, as I recreate this, I am a Dunkin' Donuts apologist. Coffee, donuts, the whole works. That's what you get for growing up in the Midwest. Anyway, here we go.
If you were to steal donuts and resell them as your own, why in the world would you choose Dunkin'? That's like purposely cheating off the kid with the worst grade. So dumb.
Disagree. Oh.
I love that this bothered him so much. He's such a Dunkin' apologist. I'm a fan of the coffee. Like, whenever we go back to the East Coast, like, we make it a point to always get our coffee from Dunkin'. But the donuts, honestly, I feel like many other donut places have kind of jumped ahead of them.
I mean, we're definitely living in a donut world these days, for sure. There are many options.
And I was all about their Munchkins, which are like their Timbits.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yes, right? Those freaking ruled. All right, here's our next comment about this vegan bakery selling Dunkin' Donuts.
What's the problem? They make a profit, don't they? If those weirdo vegan people can't tell if the donut is vegan, then that's their problem.
I guess their vegan dar is not working.
No.
A vegan donut? What a miserable way to live life!
There are some bad vegan donuts I've experienced. Some are really good. I can't remember. Mighty O's Donuts, I think they're all vegan. And their donuts, they figured it out. And there's a couple other places I've had that are pretty damn good. But some, you're like, what the hell is this crap?
No.
Here's our next comment about the vegan donuts.
And they were the best donuts the vegans ever had. The end.
Unless you have some whack-ass tummy issues, why would anybody be a f***ing vegan?
Steve, do you have whack-ass tummy issues?
It's all whack-ass. That's why I'm a plant-based weirdo with my whack-ass tummy.
I just came here to say I once dated a vegan. And it was awful. 10 out of 10 do not recommend.
Thanks for sharing, buddy.
I donut care. Get it? Donut care? It's like don't.
That was dumb.
Yep.
We have one more comment about the vegan bakery selling Dunkin' Donuts.
Wait, there's meat and donuts? What the f***?
Wow.
Yeah, it's sausage and all donuts.
Come on, haven't you had those bacon maple bars?
No, that's fair.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good point, yes. Or you could be like my parents, who whenever my wife, who is vegan, and you know, myself eating the plant-based stuff as well, they'll be like, hey, we were thinking about getting some lobster. That's vegan, right? I'm like, no. How many times do we have to go over this?
The Daily Migs Show.
Rockaholics, have you ever been catfished or duped by someone? Call us up right now, 206-803-ROCK.
A quick shout out to all the Rockaholics that are texting and calling right now. I feel less alone.
I am shocked by the number of calls and texts that we have gotten.
Amazing.
I hope we can get to everyone. Dolan in Covington, someone showed up not as what they advertised, yeah?
Yeah, you know, we had been talking for a little bit. We agreed to meet up at a date, and she shows up, and I'll be respectful, but I will say there was a significant difference between what she looked like and what she was. She was over 100, 200, I mean, like, so, and, you know, like, there's no spark, but, you know, I'm a gentleman. I'm not going to, you know, I've never ditched bought out of a date, even a bad one. But like 15 minutes later, she starts making up this excuse, and I can just tell it's a lie. She's like, oh, I have to go. Work needs me or something. And she bails. And I'm like, really?
I would love to know her side if like she was just like, this guy's not exactly what I thought he said he was going to be. He totally, you know what I mean? Wouldn't that be crazy?
I have the follow-up, and it gets weirder.
Awesome. Let's go, Dolan.
She knew my neighbor. My neighbor calls me like, hey, did you go on a really bad date? I'm like, how did you know this? Like, because she's in my living room. She's talking about it. Can you come over?
Whoa.
So I come over, and apparently she thought I was so dreamy and all these things. She didn't know how to handle it. So she came back with this 8-step plan of how we were going to try this again. And I was like, I'm sorry. There wasn't a spark, and the fact that you lied and all this went down, like, I just don't see this moving forward.
Hey, and Dolan. Did step one and step two involve handcuffs in the basement?
Thankfully, no. Okay. I had my eye on the exit, though, so you know I was ready for that hat and hat.
That's crazy. I would love to know the 8 steps. Did you find out?
No, but I kept putting very firm boundaries. She kept showing up with food, and like I was like on a strict diet at the time, and I'm like, I've already eaten. Well, it's vegetables. This, I'm like, ma'am, I've already got my macros, I've already got my nutrients. Like, she'd do these little things, and I'd have to like find the most politically correct. Okay, I'm going to return this dish fully washed. I'm gonna like, I mean, it was just, she was showing up inside my apartment for a bit. Like, I hope she's doing better, but it was not a good date.
Damn, Dolan, busting out the macros as a reason for that. I get it.
We've got Beck in Shelton. Another one that showed up not what they advertised. Yeah, maybe?
Yeah. So early
2000s online dating before you got to trade pictures and stuff, and you just had to rely on kind of what they said.
Right.
So I was up further in the peninsula, and she was down in the Puyallup, Tacoma area. So advertised as slim, cute. She had an accent. We did talk on the phone, and she, to her credit, she did have a great personality. You know, she said, I'm a redhead. I've got glasses. You know, I think she was a web designer, which, you know, was kind of new at the time, but, so go down to meet her, and the weather was terrible, just awful. Drive across the, there was only one Narrows Bridge at the time. So I get down there, and, her roommates turned out to be her parents.
Oh, like Sarah.
Yeah. And, her slim was maybe an 80 pound soaking wet, and I was like, do you eat? You are, I mean, like almost sickly. And Welsh turned out to be Welsh don't have they do have cool accents, but they don't have good hygiene.
Oh.
So yeah. So she was nice. We still went to dinner, and then I got stuck on the other side of the bridge because they closed it due to high winds. So I ended up staying in these people's spare bedroom for the night, and promptly dipped as soon as that bridge opened.
Oh, I probably would have slept in my car. Just saying, you know what? I don't even worry. I don't even take the chance.
I get the wrong idea here.
This is a little much. That is tough.
David,
you ever wonder, like, when someone says they're a certain way and they look a certain way, like, eventually we're going to meet.
Yeah.
So how about just be as close to honest? I understand, like, sometimes you just kind of, like, you might fudge the numbers. Not that I'm saying you have to give it, like, an exact size. But when you're not what you're saying you are, don't unless you think I'm going to win them over my personality and they're just going to look past however I look.
Are you shaming me for what it says I weigh on my driver's license that I have not updated in about 20 years?
Oh, I haven't updated mine either. I don't even know what mine says, to be honest with
you. If anyone looked at my ID, they'd be like, yeah, all right.
Oh, okay, see, mine is just pure laziness. I'm like, just whatever it says is good.
The Daily Migs Show.
What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids do a classroom? Homes.com knows these are all things you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law. This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids do a classroom? Homes.com knows these are all things you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
If the last few years have taught us anything, it's that human connection means the world. By connecting with one another, we know we're not alone. By connecting, we feel what others feel. We breathe better, laugh easier, and feel healthier. At Regions, connection is at the heart of everything we do. It inspires our commitment to our communities and to you. Here, health isn't just a you thing, it's a we thing. Regions Blue Shield, together we health.
The Daily Migs Show presents the most popular radio game on this side of the speaker. Let's play Beat Migs.
Beat Migs, don't be a loser.
Who's ready to beat Migs? I know Terry from Everett is. Terry, are you there? Terry? Hello?
Terry.
Hello.
Hi. You're there? Can you hear us?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Perfect. Now we can. I'm Sarah, your host, and it's time for you to get out of here, Steve.
Bye-bye.
For those playing at home, Terry has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you'll only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
How many continents are in the world?
7.
Correct. When it comes to technology, what does PC stand for?
Personal computer.
Yes. Luis Castillo was on what MLB team before the Mariners?
Oh, crap. Rangers.
No.
Indians.
No.
New York.
No. Same as a type of meat, what is the name of the piggy bank in Toy Story?
Oh, pass.
Hartford is the capital of which U.S. state?
Connecticut.
Yes. How do you write 30 in Roman numerals?
30 is XXX.
Yes. Lady Gaga's fans are known as Little what?
Little Gagas.
No.
Little guys, I have a pass.
Who directed the 80s movie Raiders of the Lost Ark?
Oh, Steven Spielberg.
Yes.
Wait, I have a question real quick, Sarah.
Okay.
Would you have also gone with Kentucky for the...
Stop! No, I wouldn't have. Terry, you got 5 correct.
Eat up all my time.
I ate up all your time?
No, asking about Kentucky.
Oh, no, that was way after the buzzer.
Yeah.
That was No. You were out of time way before that. We can blame Danny, though, if you want.
Wow.
That's fine.
No.
Steve, are you ready?
Oh, yeah!
How many continents are there in the world?
7.
Yes. When it comes to technology, what does PC stand for?
Personal computer.
Correct. Luis Castillo was on what MLB team before the Mariners?
He's pitching tonight. Cincinnati Reds.
Yes. Same as a type of meat, what is the name of the piggy bank in Toy Story?
Bacon?
No.
Rump roast?
No.
Steak?
No. Hartford is the capital of which U.S. state?
Connecticut.
Yes. How do you write 30 in Roman numerals?
Triple X.
XXX. Yes. Lady Gaga's fans are known as Little what?
Pains in my butt.
No.
Little Monsters.
Yes. Who directed the 80s movie Raiders of the Lost Ark?
Steven Spielberg.
Correct. Chris Hemsworth is from what country?
Thorland.
Yeah.
England?
No.
France?
No.
I don't know. Canada.
No. Two Broke Girls originally aired on what network?
Oh, man. Love that show. NBC.
No.
Fox.
No.
CBS.
Yes. How much do you love it, really?
I DVR it and watch it. Like, I know what channel it's on.
Well, Steve, you got 8 correct, which is a win, 8-5. Terry, I'm so sorry.
Terry already
hung up.
He gave up.
Wow. That was a pretty good performance.
Thank you. I love that show. No idea what network it's on.
But I love it, I swear. Same name as a type of meat. You were on the right track. Piggy bank is?
Pork chop.
No.
Oh, does he call him pork chop? That's what he calls him, evil Dr. Pork Chop. That's his nickname for him.
Yes.
But he's playing.
I thought you were talking.
Ham?
Yeah, it's ham. I thought you were talking about Doug for a second.
But that's a good show. But considering how much we watch Toy Story, I'm very disappointed I didn't know.
You should be. You should ask Barrett because he probably knows.
He would absolutely know.
I asked Barrett and he had this to say about that.
That's why I'm sick of you.
I would be sick of my mom, too, if she got my favorite movie characters wrong. I get it, Barrett.
And that's why I'm sick of you.
Crims Hemsworth is from?
Scotland?
Down Under.
Oh.
Australia?
Yeah.
Can you do an Australian accent, Steve?
Oi.
Crikey.
I'm from Australia. Oi.
Nailed it.
Thank you.
Oi?
Oi.
Oi.
Crikey.
God, make it
Boomerang.
Stop.
Kangaroo.
Joey. Hey.
Oh, my.
That's why I'm sick of you.
Yeah.
Me too, Barrett. Me too.
The Daily Migs Show.
When did you blow it? When did you screw up and you'll never live it down? 206-803-ROCK. Kevin in Lake Stevens, you scored a goal against your own team.
Oh, man, no.
So I played 8 years of outdoor soccer, and the one goal I ever made was against my own team. I was playing right center forward. I was down on our goal, getting the ball away from another forward, and it was the finale of the game, and it was I was going to take it down to the other side to get it in for the winning point. And when I went to block the ball from going into our goal, it bounced off my foot, went right into our goal, killed it. I never played soccer ever.
No!
Wait, you stopped playing soccer because of that?
He retired.
Oh, man.
And how old were you?
13 at the time.
Did you have any other sports that you enjoyed playing that you could fall back on?
I'm sticking with baseball now.
No, definitely not. I was very engulfed in Boy Scouts and furthering my life in that aspect. Well, and I completed as an Eagle Scout.
You're an Eagle Scout? No way!
Yes.
You know, Mike Hawk from the men's room is also an Eagle Scout.
Oh, really?
And my brother, Nolan, cool. Also an Eagle Scout.
Yeah, but Mike or Nolan have never scored on their own team in soccer. Hey, dude, I don't know if you ever know if you're a hockey fan, but I remember still when I was a kid, the Edmonton Oilers were like trying to make a run for like their fifth straight Stanley Cup or something along those lines. And they're one of their star defensemen, I think it was like Steve Smith, I can't remember. He had it back behind the net, and this is overtime. And it's like game 7, and he's trying to pass it to someone, and instead he accidentally shot it off his own goalie's skate. And it went in the net, or one of his own players, I can't remember. And I was just like, that has to be the worst, because there's no recovering. It's not like, oh, we'll get him next game. It's like, our season is done. We're not going to win a Stanley Cup. Thanks, Mr. Smith.
It's the worst feeling ever.
Oh, I bet. Thanks a lot, Kevin.
Drama in Covington, you got in a car accident on a first date.
Good morning, my beautiful friends. How are you?
Morning.
What's
so
up, Drama?
Good, man.
Well, yes, so I was on a first date. It was going well. We had dinner. Everything was going back. And this was before Netflix and chill. This was Hollywood Video and Get Some Days.
The good old days.
Old school.
Yeah. Not Blockbuster and Bang.
Yeah. And I'm like, oh, she picked out some movie I didn't even care for because that wasn't the point. I was thinking ahead. We're going back to her place. Get on the on-ramp to get on the interstate. And it wasn't even my fault. That's the thing. And got in a car accident, and she was in the car, and then afterwards she was all freaked out, which naturally I get, but then she wouldn't return my calls, and she was like, nah, I don't think we should see. So I'm like, you know, you acted like I wanted to total my card on purpose, you know, when I didn't. At least the guy that just called before, at least he scored, even if it was for the wrong team.
Solid point.
Oh, man, you rock, Drama. Thanks for the call. Dude, we got a text about someone who also screwed up a date. It said, the way I blew it, I met a girl at jiu-jitsu, and we were really hitting it off. We started flirting a little bit, and we agreed to hang sometime soon. Well, later on that week, while we were sparring, I unintentionally kicked her in the face and broke her nose.
Oh.
When she finally came back to train, she was always, quote-unquote, busy when I asked to hang out.
I would imagine that two people that are both trained in jiu-jitsu probably can have a lot of fun between the sheets.
Yeah, but I think I might have to go to a different jiu-jitsu school. Because what if, like, you're sparring and then all of a sudden it just kind of, like, it ignites a certain flame below the waist?
Yeah. These are real problems,
I don't
Steve.
Know if that could be used as a weapon in jiu-jitsu or not. Or someone said I once got into an argument with the manager of a bar once. I was told that I was cut off that night because I was so drunk. I said I wasn't drunk at all. Spoiler alert, I was. Well, I was dating a new girl at the time, and when I met her parents, yep, that was her dad, that was the manager.
No.
I didn't remember it was him, but he did, and he brought it up, and well, she broke up with me that night. She texted me when I got home and said, my dad forgives you, but I can't.
That is heartbreaking.
See, I feel like that's a fun, bad first impression that you could kind of get past.
We laugh about it. We talk about it at Thanksgiving every year.
Right, be like, dad, yeah, you were right. I was out of line. Unless he said something terrible to the dad, and then the dad told his daughter that's what he said.
I mean, I'm sure that managers of bars have had many of those ridiculous, drunken conversations with people that have no sense at all.
All right, what about you? When have you blown it?
So I missed a meet and greet.
It doesn't involve knuckles, of course.
No, it does not involve knuckles.
Okay, good.
I missed a meet and greet with Joe Walsh by 10 minutes. And it was kind of my own fault. You've been up to Vancouver a gazillion times. Have you ever been stuck in Massey tunnel traffic?
Yes.
And it can be awful.
No, there is no fun way to get through to. Once you cross that border, it's like you're effed if there's traffic. There's no fun ways around it.
So we were already running a little bit late. We got stuck in Massey tunnel traffic, and then we needed to check into the hotel before we could go to the show. And I was trying to drive kind of quick in the parking garage. And when I took a corner, the side of my car scraped against one of the giant, like, cement pillars.
Yeah.
So now I'm really upset. I'm like, we're running late. The traffic sucked. Now my car is scraped. And then we still missed the meet and greet by about 10 minutes.
Is Joe Walsh still here?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't know if he passed away or not. So there's still hope.
I mean, maybe. I hope so. And the show ended up being fantastic. But we were sitting kind of front and center, very close to the stage. And I'm like, yes, this is close. These are good seats. But I could have been meeting Joe Walsh an hour ago.
For the next 2 hours, you're being reminded of what happened.
It was brutal. Yeah.
The Daily Migs Show.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law. This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
The Daily Migs Show presents the Extreme Music Showdown. Let's play Hook or Shook. Please sign this waiver before we continue. Thank you. We'll drop a 1 second snippet of the hook of a song. If you can't name the song, watch out, you're gonna get shook.
It is time to play Hook or Shook. And Alonzo in Des Moines, we certainly hope that we're gonna see you at the show as well.
What's up, Alonzo?
Hey, how's it going?
We're doing great, man. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah.
All right, Alonzo, you have to get both songs right to win. The first song, you will be on your own. The second song, this is where you can get shook because a member of our show at random must get it right for you. If not, you lose and caller 9 will get the tickets. So let's see who you are playing with. Will it be me, Migs, or Sarah?
Steve, Sarah. I believe he's going to land on Sarah again.
Why does the wheel love Sarah so much?
Why not?
Oh, Alonzo, I'm keeping my fingers crossed and holding on to some faith here, brother.
All right.
Are you ready for your first clip?
Yes.
Here we go. Want to hear it again?
Yes, please. Sounds like Kid Rock.
No.
Let's
play it for him again.
Is that your final end? Okay, here we go. One more time.
We can give you a hint, Alonzo. We can have Sarah give you a hint.
Okay, yeah. So I'd take a hint.
Okay.
Amy Lee.
All right, so that's Evanescence.
Hey, baby!
Now, what's the song?
Let's play the clip one more time for him.
Jeez, what's the name of that song?
I can give you another hint for the song.
Oh, look at you, yes. Miss Confidence.
Look, I know! If I'm dead, but I want to be alive, you have to
pick him up.
What? Is that not a good clue?
No, keep it going. This is fantastic.
Alonzo, does that help?
Is it called Wake Me Up? A little bit. Is it called Wake Me Up?
Oh, no. I'm so sorry, Alonzo.
Oh, man, it's Bring Me to Life. So close.
So close, Alonzo. We wish the tables had turned differently.
Can we say, though?
I'm impressed that we got the hint on Amy Lee. I thought he was going to be like, that's a porn star or something like that.
Kind of sounds like that. And can we say, that wasn't my fault at all?
No, you tried your best.
You did good, Sarah. We're proud of you.
I tried my best.
I'll be honest with you. I couldn't think of the name of the song either. I think, is it Wake Me Up Inside?
Wake me up before you.
Okay, I said wake me up inside.
Sorry.
The Daily Migs Show.
Rockaholics, all morning long, we have received your text messages, we have fielded your calls, and we want to catch up on all the things you want to chat about this morning. So if there's something on your mind, now's a great time to call us up, 206-803-ROCK. Rob in Port Orchard, you met Lofa Tatupu. We were talking about being starstruck and meeting famous people. You met Lofa Tatupu.
Seahawks great.
Yeah, that's right, I did. So... by the way, Taryn, you're doing a great job.
Hey, thanks. I appreciate you, man.
So, my son comes from Tri-Cities all the time, and we'll sit down at the stadium and wait for tickets to go to a super low price. So, we're waiting around for the Seahawks-Steelers game to start. And as you know, all the bars are always crowded before the Seahawks games. So... we're bar hopping. We're trying to find a place to sit. Anyway, earlier, I asked my wife, what jersey should I wear to the game? She said, you should wear Tyler Lockett. And I went upstairs, and I don't know, I have at least 25 jerseys.
What? Damn. That's an investment.
I was going through them, and I said, no, I'm going to go old school. And for some apparent reason, I picked out Lofa Tutupu's
nice
jersey. And we're just, like I say, we're just out there bar hopping. We come across this bar. We finally get a seat in a bar. And they're doing a fundraiser for veterans to go skiing. And I heard the DJ at the bar say, oh, and here's Lofa Tatupu. Well, I just thought it was some guy donating money that was wearing his jersey as well. So we're just sitting there drinking. And then the DJ says, oh, we're taking pictures with Lofa Tatupu if you want to get it for 10 more minutes. So sure enough, I went up there, and there he was. I don't know even what the odds of that are.
Dude, I bet he was fired up to see you rocking his jersey.
Oh, he totally signed my jersey.
Yes.
And He told me, I've never signed, I don't think he told me, I don't think I've ever signed the number 5, so you have a one of a kind. So, yeah, I think he was pretty stoked that I was rocking his jersey.
That's awesome.
So, I don't even know what the chances of that are, picking out a one out of 25 jerseys and going to a bar that I don't even know he's going to be at.
Right. And then you could go back to your wife and be like, Tyler Lockett wouldn't have been at the bar. He was busy playing, so I made the right choice.
Thanks, Rob. Vincent in Tumwater, earlier we were talking about what crazy things we may have paid for, what crazy things we may have been paid to do. You paid your best friend to act excited to impress people.
Yeah. Hey, how you guys doing in the morning?
We're doing good. Great, my man.
Hey, so my name is Specialist Naylor. I'm with the Washington Army National Guard. So I am a recruiter for the National Guard. And so when I first started this job...
Oh, I thought you were about to... I was like, dude, I might be a little too old. I'm sorry.
Steve is past his prime.
Yeah, you don't want me. I'm out of shape.
17 to 35, man.
Definitely.
So I was a new recruiter, and it was really hard because it's a job that relies on the decisions of other people for us to succeed. And so right. my best friend at the time, he's in the guard with me. I paid him $50 to act almost like extremely over the top, really overzealous. Oh my God, you changed my life. Thank you so much. Because I was working with this one guy that I just, you know, couldn't really get excited. I couldn't really figure him out. And so I had to pay my best friend about $50 for him to come in and be like, oh my God, you're awesome. You know, thank you so much. You know, I had the applicant be like, oh my God, dude, the National Guard can do that for me? What? What?
So it worked.
Right. Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, the National Guard's always a great place to be, you know, it's a part-time military service. So,
hey, Vincent, real quick question for you. I don't know if you have a story about this. I might be just throwing you a weird loophole of a question because obviously you're recruiting people to get into this world. Do you keep tabs on them? And do you have like an incredible success story or someone that you were just like, man, this guy definitely needs something in his life to turn his life around, and it ended up being the National Guard?
Absolutely. So I can't really name drop, but I had – this one guy who came up to me, you know, he had some previous legal stuff going on, you know, with drugs and stuff like that. And he came up to me. He was an old friend of mine. And he said, you know, dude, I'm really down bad. You know, I don't know. You know, I'm living out of my car. I'm, you know, X, Y, and Z. And I said, you know what, man? Hey, come into the office. Let's talk about it. So we have over 150 different career fields that they get to choose from. And all he has to do is see if he's mentally and physically fit. So he comes in. He puts in the work. I've never seen anybody put more in the work because they were just so motivated to, one, get out of a bad situation, but also, you know, serve their country and their community, the state, right? It's part-time service, only 1 week in a month, 2 weeks in the summer, things like that. And so he comes in, and he scored like an 85 in the ASVAB, which is extremely high, right? Those where you can get job, like life-changing career opportunities, top secret clearances, and things like that that we, you know, we can't really talk about. But right now, he has his own house, he has his own awesome wife and kids, and you know, he's doing great things, and man, I'm so proud to see where he's coming from. Sorry.
No, dude, that's badass. I got goosebumps hearing you tell that.
That's amazing.
When you said how he's ended up with kids and a house and a wife, that's awesome to hear.
The Daily Migs Show.
You know, I never really worked in a place where tipping was, like, customary. Never had one of those jobs. Except for the time that I worked at the Naughty Car Wash. And there, occasionally, we'd get a really good tip, like $10, $20. It'd be exciting. And just to clarify, not naughty in like that way. We were just,
you guys were
not
thieves,
good kids.
And you guys were tipping yourselves by just stealing the money.
Well, that too. But sometimes we get excited. There was this one guy that drove a Range Rover, and he'd pull up, and we'd be like, "Oh my God, Range Rover's here!" Like we knew we'd get like a $20 tip. It'd be very exciting.
Okay, and then on top of it, you're also pocketing the money that he paid for the car wash. So
maybe just a portion. 206-803 Rock. We're asking, what is the best tip you ever received? Rockaholics, and the reason why is because there was a customer at a restaurant in Michigan who gave the staff a $10,000 tip.
What?
On a $30 bill. And it was in honor of a friend that had just passed away.
I don't even know what the percentage is on that. That's more than my usual 25%.
Ava was one
just
of the servers.
Just by a tap, yeah.
Ava got a portion of the tip, just the tip. And here is her talking about this very generous customer.
I know he was drinking coffee. His bill was only like $30, so
the tip was like a very big tip. We do have that time where it's we're not making as much money as in the summer, but I mean, everyone goes through things, and I know it's hard sometimes, but you know, you never know what or who is going to bless you.
That's insane. $10,000.
If you were going to leave behind some money, where would your tip go?
Do we want the after dark answer or the before dark answer?
Well, is there a place that, you know, after your passing that you'd want them to know how much they meant to you?
Yes. There would be a couple places. I'm a fan of going to a coffee stand and they know your name. Not their name, know your order. I don't care if you know my name. Just know my order. Mm-hmm. And there's a couple places that are like right around me in the Puyallup area. Like there's Bigfoot Java. I love it. The baristas there are awesome. They're super friendly. So I wouldn't mind. Like, that'd be pretty awesome. Like, even during the holidays, I always try and tip way more than I usually would. Just be like, hey, you guys are badass. There's a new one that we recently have been going to that I can't remember the name of it, though. It's like Rescue Me Coffee.
Mm.
And it's like right in Puyallup, and their coffee's amazing, too. So
we talked to some bikini baristas a few weeks ago that were talking about crazy coffee stand tips that they were getting, like,
these are
$1,000.
Yeah, one got new boobs. One got new boobs. I'm not paying for that.
You'll not be blessed.
Yeah, I have a question, though, talking about tips, because they did say that they were sharing the tip at this place. And Sarah, you worked at a restaurant.
I did, yes, for many years.
I'm curious of what your opinion is on this then. Do you like sharing tips with your coworkers, or do you, because part of me, and this might be a very unpopular opinion, I don't know, maybe it's a popular opinion. If I worked as a waiter and I was killing it and getting good tips and the other waiters around me weren't killing it and they were getting bare minimum tips, I don't want to share my hard work with those bastards.
I completely agree with you.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So at the restaurant I worked at, the servers take home their own tips, but we had to tip out like the busser and the kitchen and the bartender.
And I'm fine with that part.
Yes. Yes. Same. But I know a lot of restaurants, they pool all of their tips together. So all the servers pool their tips together and then they divvy it out.
Okay. So follow up question to that. In your experience, when you were tipping out the bussers and the kitchen staff, was it a percentage?
It's a percentage.
And it was the same percentage all the time?
Yes, yes. So it's usually like 2% for each.
Yeah, it'd be annoying. Like, let's just say you did a kick-ass job with a table, and they're like, you know what? We're going to hook you up with a $100 tip. And like, let's just say that's way more than the 20-ish percent that some people would be giving. I mean, I'd be okay with like, hey, take the 20% of that, but everything after that 20% goes in my pocket, and I'm not sharing it with Gladys over there because she sucks as a waitress.
The Daily Migs Show. Knowledge is power. So give us 5-ish minutes and we'll give you some interesting stuff you can talk about at work. This is the Daily Migs download,
aka the DMD.
Here's your daily dose of doings happening in the world.
And the DMD is brought to you by Backwards Hats. No, the DMD is brought to you by Palace Law. Oh man, when you're thinking about barbecues, what do you think is an essential to put on the grill?
Like, of anything?
Anything.
Well, burgers if you're doing a barbecue.
What if you don't want burgers? What if you want brats?
Okay, you can do brats. It's fine. You can do whatever. Choose your own adventure.
Danny likes the barbecue. What are you going with?
Oh, I'm doing ribs all day.
Ribs. That's a must-have on the grill.
It has to be.
Sarah?
Vegetables?
Do you put them in the tinfoil?
Oh, yeah.
A bunch of, like, crap and then throw it on the grill?
Yeah, well, I don't, but my husband does.
Same. My wife does it.
You know what
makes
vegetables even better? Meat.
Meat on top of it?
Are you telling me that your wife is the grill master?
No, she prepares the vegetables.
Oh! I thought you had a sexy grill master at home, and I was like,
no,
yes,
I'm just out there getting everything ready, and then she just hands me this giant tinfoil ball of vegetables, and I put it on the grill first because it takes forever for them to get all nice and tasty.
What do you like to grill?
The essential? I gotta have it with every time that we barbecue. Corn. Corn on the cob, baby.
Corn on the cob is delicious.
It's a must-have. If we don't have corn, we ain't barbecuing. That's the rule of my house.
I like that. Right. Said with confidence.
You know, maybe this weekend we'll be barbecuing for Father's Day. Father's Day is this Sunday, and you might want to be nicer to your dad, a.k.a. me, a.k.a. Danny.
Yeah.
Reason being, according to a study, they say that you've been slowly killing your father all these years because you basically are giving him added stress, added responsibilities that comes with being a parent. I don't know why it doesn't apply to the moms as well, but according to the study, we're going to go with it. That's what they're saying. So because of you kids, your dads are getting
They're aging.
Aging quicker than they should. They even say, though, if you have a kid under 20, I mean, if you're a dad at the age of 25 or younger, you're even at a higher risk. So, phew, dodge that bullet.
Danny, sorry about you.
Yeah, so anyways, there you go. Do you already know what you're getting for Father's Day?
No idea.
My daughter's terrible at keeping secrets. The minute they got it in the mail, she gave me my Father's Day gift, which was last week.
Was this the socks?
I have socks. And I'm not a sock guy, but now I am a sock guy because she bought me, or mom bought it for her, socks with Tatum's face all over them, and they are amazing.
Well, now I know what I'm going to get for Brad. It's a great idea.
Socks with Tatum's face?
No, socks with Barrett's face. There's a resort town in Spain that has been well known for rowdy parties, but they have banned public displays of adult inflatables.
This place sounds like Sarah's destination. To a nutshell.
It's called Platea de Oro, and it has become a hotspot for bachelor and bachelorette parties. But of the 12,000 residents in that town, they're not super appreciative of all of this.
But they don't want wiener straws and wiener hats and all the other stuff that come with bachelorette parties?
Blow-up dolls, costumes that resemble male anatomy, all of that has been banned. Visitors are also required to wear clothes in addition to underwear. And then visitors who violate this law will get a fine of up to $1,600. So there was a recent bachelor party that made this rule go into effect because they used tape to tie a groom-to-be to a lamppost and blared loud music.
Well, it seems like an isolated incident. I don't know why you're punishing everybody else because of what this... what kind of friends do you have that tape you to a pole? And then I'm imagining he probably wasn't wearing much.
This sounds like the plot to The right? Hangover 4 or something like that.
This also answers the question. For the longest time when I was younger, I used to always wonder who are the people that buy these inflatable love toys?
Yeah.
But then it makes sense. They're just gag gifts. Poor choice of words. But they're joke gifts for bachelor and bachelorette parties. Does anyone actually, put those things to use?
I'm sure there are people out there, Steve.
Those things are so weird.
They are so weird. And when I was moving recently, there was one under my bed.
Who put it there?
I don't know. Probably me or a friend or something.
What if it was your dad?
Oh, my.
Or
no,
your brother. No. Or your brother.
Did you leave it for your dad as a housewarming gift?
No. And to my surprise, George didn't want it either, so we gave it to Goodwill. I don't know if they're going
to
want it.
You gave it to Goodwill? Was it open?
Yeah, it was blown up and everything.
Talking about the mouth? Or
when have you ever been to a Value Village or a Salvation Army where there are blow-up dolls available for purchase? You know they just threw that thing away.
Why did you think that was going to be a good idea?
Also, this would need to be its own section of Goodwill, the secondhand.
Like the old video stores where you went through this weird curtain and that's where all the adult films were.
Yeah.
So at a Value Village, there's a weird curtain and it's a bunch of these?
Yeah, I couldn't throw her away. She was already just looking so surprised, so I just put her in the Goodwill pile.
Newsflash, Goodwill threw her away.
Aww.
There's no chance they resold that thing. There's not a chance in hell. Hey, as far as weather, we're going to hit a high of 75 degrees. Another great day to go check out your Seattle Mariners who are at home taking on the Chicago White Sox. That is the DMD, and that's what's up.
The Daily Migs Show.
You don't just live in your home. You live in your neighborhood as well. So when you're shopping for a home, you want to know as much about the area around it as possible. Luckily, Homes.com has got you covered. Each listing features a comprehensive neighborhood guide from local experts. Everything you'd ever want to know about a neighborhood, including the number of homes for sale, transportation, local amenities, cultural attractions, unique qualities, and even things like median lot size and a noise score. Homes.com. We've done your homework.
This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Granger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Granger.com, or just stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
This episode is brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Whether you love true crime or comedy, celebrity interviews or news, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. And guess what? Now you can call them on your auto insurance too with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. It works just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance and they'll show you coverage options that fit your budget. Get your quote today at progressive.com to join the over 28 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.